Good morning, dear students. Welcome to our class of economics. We were studying the consumer's behavior, and in this connection I had explained what is the cardinal utility analysis or the Marshallian utility analysis. Today we will see the second approach of the consumer's equilibrium, which was given by two different economists, Hicks and Allen. So this ordinal utility approach is also known as Hicks-Allen indifference curve approach. So Marshallian utility approach or cardinal utility approach, Hicks-Allen indifference curve approach or ordinal utility approach. Now this ordinal utility approach, it initially criticized the cardinal utility approach. How it criticized? In my last class I told you, according to Alfred Marshall or Marshallian utility analysis, utility can be measured cardinally, and that assumption was challenged by ordinal utility approaches. That means you are thirsty, you asked for a glass of water, I gave you a glass of water, you drank that glass of water, and now according to cardinal utility analysis, if I ask you how much satisfaction you derived, you say that you got 12 utils of satisfaction. So what is the basis of saying 12 utils of satisfaction? Why didn't you say 100 utils of satisfaction? There was no satisfactory answer of this question in the cardinal utility analysis or Marshallian utility analysis. One thing more, see, just try to understand. Two of your friends came to me and both expressed that they were thirsty. I gave each of them a glass full of water. Both of them drank that water. And after that I asked, what level of satisfaction, what degree of satisfaction you got? One of your friend told 12 utils, the other told 20 utils. So from the figures that they are giving to me, 12 utils and 20 utils, I will conclude that the one who said that 20 utils of satisfaction he or she derived by consuming a glass of water was more thirsty than the other one. Because since he or she was more thirsty, that's why the same amount of water gave him or her more satisfaction than the other. So basically, it may be possible the other way also. Among those two friends of yours, the friend who described his satisfaction as 12 utils may be more thirsty than the other. It may be the case. But cardinal theory, cardinal utility analysis failed to describe this problem. They only said that utility is cardinally measurable, and it can be expressed by certain numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, and units of measuring satisfaction or utility is utils. A development on the cardinal utility analysis is the ordinal utility approach given by two economists, Hicks and Allen. And this utility approach says, it talks about ordinal measurement of utility. What it means? It means that utility or the want satisfying power in a commodity cannot be measured in terms of a certain number, cannot be measured cardinally, but it can be measured ordinally. Ordinally measurement means, suppose you are thirsty and I place two bottles of cold drinks before you and ask to take any one of the two. One is the bottle of Sprite, the other one is bottle of thumbs up. You took bottle of Sprite. You were free to take any of the two. You took the bottle of Sprite. It means that you prefer bottle of Sprite to bottle of thumbs up or any other drink. So what we can say that what which good will give me more satisfaction, but by how much, it is very difficult to say. Cardinal theory analysis says that which one is preferred, what is the exact amount of satisfaction which is obtained from the bottle of Sprite as well as from the bottle of thumbs up. But ordinal theory analysis says, no, you cannot measure the satisfaction or utility in terms of certain cardinal number. Rather, you can order the utility. They can be ranked. So this is their thing. It talks about the ordinal measurement of utility. Utility derived by consuming a certain units of a commodity cannot be measured cardinally by using some cardinal numbers as it was assumed in Marshallian utility analysis. Rather, the utility or satisfaction that we derive by consumption of different commodities can be ranked or preferred. This ordinal utility approach deals with two commodities. In case of cardinal utility analysis, we have learned consumer's equilibrium in case of one commodity, and then in case of two commodities, which I told that it was also known as the law of equimarginal utility, where the ratio of the marginal utility derived from different commodities to its price will be equal. That is, if we are consuming two commodities, one and two, then mu1 by p1 is equal to mu2 by p2. We have seen that one. But here it is said that ordinal utility approach deals in two commodities always. It will never work with one commodity. Some important terms we will go through. Consumption bundle. We are supposing that our consumer is consuming two commodities at a time. So suppose commodity 1 and commodity 2. Now a bundle which contains both the commodities, some units of commodity 1 and some units of commodity 2, is known as the commodity bundle. Commodity bundle or consumption bundle. Suppose there is mangoes and apples are two commodities. Commodity 1 is mango, commodity 2 is apples. Now if I say that it is 10, 8, just like coordinate geometry that you have learned in standard 10. 10, 8, 10 is the abscissa, 8 is the ordinate. Here, suppose this is commodity 1 and this one is the commodity. First one is commodity 1 and the second one is commodity 2. Commodity 1 is mango, commodity 2 is apple. 10 units of mangoes and 8 units of apples, this is one commodity bundle. Similarly, 2, 5, 7, 9, like that, n number of commodity bundles can be there. But remember, the numbers that we are writing within the bracket to represent the commodity bundle, that should be the integral, unit. That means it cannot be 10.5, it cannot be 8.4. It will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That means integers will be there. Within the bracket, within the commodity bundles, two commodities will be present and they will be present as integers. So now, what is consumption bundle or commodity bundle? It is a combination of the quantities of two goods. Let there be two goods, mangoes and apples. Now, if we write consumption bundle or commodity bundle 10A, it means that this bundle, in this bundle, there are 10 mangoes and 8 apples. Next one is the budget set. Consumption bundle we have done. We have understood what is consumption bundle or commodity bundle. It is a bag. It is a bundle which contains two commodities, mangoes and apples. 10 mangoes and 8 apples. Now, budget set. Our consumer is having a limited money income, and the prices of mangoes and apples are given in the market. Now, with his limited money income, what are the different combination of the commodity bundles consisting of two commodities, mangoes and apples, that our consumer can buy is known as the commodity set. So, what is a commodity? What is a budget set? Budget set means our consumer is having limited amount of money income. We are doing with two commodities, mangoes and apples. Their prices in the market are given and constant. With that limited money income, by spending that limited money income, what are the various commodity bundles that our consumer can purchase is known as the budget set. Now see, all commodity bundles that the consumer can buy using his limited money income at the prevailing market prices is known as the budget set. Definitely, this budget set depends on two things: money income of the consumer, price of both the goods that the bundle contains. If the bundle contains mangoes and apples, definitely the budget set will depend on two things: money in the pocket of the consumer and the prices of both the commodities, mangoes and apples. Let us take an example in order to make your concept clear. Let the money income with our consumer is rupees 20. The consumer is having only 20 rupees in his pocket. That is his money income that he wants to spend on two commodities. He wants to spend it on two commodities, mangoes and apples, or commodity 1 and commodity 2. The price of both the commodities in the market, for the sake of convenience, let us take to be rupees 5 per unit. Price of both the goods, let be rupees 5 per unit. Now, the budget set, our hypothetical consumer will contain of the following commodity bundles. Will contain the following commodity bundles. So, if it is the case, if the price of commodity 1 is rupees 5 per unit and price of commodity 2 is again rupees 5 per unit, and our consumer is having only 20 rupees in his pocket, now what are the different combination of the two commodities that can our consumer purchase, that our consumer can purchase, is known as the budget set. Now the thing is, see, our consumer can purchase none of the two commodities, that is 0, 0, 0 unit of mangoes and 0 unit of apples. No, he is not purchasing anything. It is his choice. He can purchase 0 mangoes, 1 apple, 0 mangoes, 2 apples, 0 mangoes, 3 apples, and 0 mango, 4 apples. What is happening? When he is purchasing 0, 0, he is not spending a single paisa. In this case, he is spending rupees 5, rupees 10, rupees 20, sorry, rupees 15 and rupees 20. He can purchase 1 0, 1 mango and 0 apple by spending rupees 5, 1 mango and 1 apple spending rupees 10, 1 mango and 2 apples spending rupees 15, 1 mango and 3 apples by spending rupees 20. He can purchase 2 0, 2 1, 2 2, similarly 3 0, 3 1 and 4 0. So there are 15. If you count the number of all these are the commodity bundles. If you count these numbers of the commodity bundles, you will find that there are 15 commodity bundles that our hypothetical consumer can have if his money income is rupees 20 and if the price of both the commodities are rupees 5 each. The total number of commodity bundles that our consumer can have with his limited money income is 20, of rupees 20 is 15. The consumer's budget, okay, it is understood. Now, one more thing you observe here, students. If our consumer is purchasing 40, his 20 rupees is exhausted. 31, again 20 rupees is exhausted. 22, 20 rupees is exhausted. 13, 04. In all these commodity bundles, if our consumer goes for all these commodity bundles, his entire money income will be exhausted. And all these commodity bundles will consist the budget line of the consumer. We will come just afterwards. The consumer budget constraint. Now we have to learn another concept. We have learned consumption bundle, budget set. Now consumer budget constraint. All those commodity bundles consisting of two commodities that our consumer cannot purchase due to his budget constraint is known as the consumer budget constraint. That means the consumer is not having enough money in his pocket to purchase these sort of commodity bundles. 0.5. You see, 0.5, 0 mangoes and 5 apples, it needs 25 rupees. Our consumer cannot purchase. 1.6, 1 apple and 6. So 1 mango and 6 apples. Total 35 rupees is needed. The consumer is having only 20 rupees. 2.8 similarly. 2 mangoes and 8 apples. So all those commodity bundles which our consumer cannot purchase due to his limited money income is known as the budget constraint. These bundles cannot be afforded by our consumer, and so these bundles do not form a part of the budget set in the example. In this example, we have given the curl bracket. In mathematics, you know, curl bracket is used to denote a set. Since we are talking about budget set, so set notation is needed, set form is needed. We have used the curl bracket, and within this curl bracket, by using the commas after each commodity bundles, I have written all the commodity bundles. These commodity bundles are affordable. Our consumer can purchase any of these 15 commodity bundles, including 00, no commodity, he is not purchasing any commodity. That will also come within the budget set. But these commodity bundles are not affordable by our consumer due to his limited money income. Now, budget line, I told you, all those commodity bundles in which the entire money of the consumer is spent are the elements of the budget line. Simply, it is also known as the price line. Budget line or price line, it is known as. A budget line represents the different bundles that the consumer can purchase spending his entire money income at given prices. So 20 rupees is there in the pocket of the consumer. 5 rupee each is the price of a mango and of an apple. Now if our consumer wants to spend his entire money income of rupees 20 over these two commodities of mangoes and apples, the different combination of the commodities or different bundles of commodity that he can purchase by total exhaustion of his rupees 20 are the elements of the budget line. A budget line represents the different bundles. It represents different commodity bundles that the consumer can purchase spending his entire money income at given prices. If the price of the commodity one is P1, so see here 04, 40, 31, 22, 13, 04 are the elements which make the budget line. Now, if the price of commodity 1 is P1 per unit and commodity 2 is P2 per unit and the money income of our consumer is denoted by capital M, then all the commodity bundles which satisfies the given equation. What is the given equation? P1 X1 plus P2 X2 equals to M will lie on the budget line. Okay, dear students, now we are, instead of giving rupees 20 as money income, rupees 5 for the price of one mango, rupees 5 the price for one apples, we are using the abstract notations. We are saying here that the consumer is having rupees M money income and the price of commodity 1 is P1 and price of commodity 2 is P2. Price of mango is P1 and price of apple is P2 per unit and M is his money income. Now suppose our consumer is purchasing X1 units of commodity 1 and X2 units of commodity 2. That means X1 units of mango and X2 units of apple. Then all those commodity bundles consisting of two commodities, commodity 1 and commodity 2, which satisfies this particular equation of P1 X1 plus P2 X2 equals to M, will lie on the budget line. That means if M is equal to 20, P1 is 5 and P2 is also 5, then 40 commodity bundle, commodity bundle 31, commodity bundle 22, commodity bundle 13, commodity bundle 04 will lie on the budget line. In the above given example, the bundles 04, 13223140 will lie on the budget line. See, now I have given a graphic representation of the budget line. I have tried to give it. Along x-axis, we are plotting commodity 1. Say, if we take mangoes at commodity 1, we are plotting units of mangoes along x-axis and units of apples on y-axis. Commodity 1 is plotted along x-axis, commodity 2 is plotted along y-axis. And now 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, we have marked our commodity bundles just in the same way as we plotted in the coordinate geometry in the Cartesian plane. This is the Cartesian plane and these are the coordinates. 0, 0, this is very 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, 3, 0, 4, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 0, 2, 1, 2, 2, 3, 0, 3, 1, 4, 0. We have darkened the spots over there. All these spots, dots represented in the diagram will represent the commodity bundle. And if you count these spots, you will find there are 15. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 15 spots are there. 15 dots are there in this diagram. Each dot represents a particular commodity bundle, dear students. So I hope this very diagram is clear to you. And here the commodity bundle A, B, C, D, E shows the fuller exhaustion of the limited money income that our consumer is having by spending on two goods, commodity 1 and commodity 2. This very line is known as the budget line of the consumer. So this is the budget line. What sort of line it is? It is a downward sloping straight line from left to right. It is a downward sloping straight line from left to right. All the points that lies on the line shows the commodity bundles in which the consumer can buy. And if the consumer buys any of the five commodity bundles A, B, C, D, E, his money is completely exhausted. Any commodity bundle like P, Q and N, which is lying inside the budget line, if our consumer goes for P or Q or N commodity bundles, it means that he will have some amount of commodity 1 and commodity 2, but still he is left with some amount of purchasing power, some amount of income will be left with his pocket. So if our consumer is purchasing A, B, C, D, E, complete money is exhausted. If he purchases commodity bundle P, Q, N and any other combination lying inside the budget line, it means he is having the two commodities, but at the same time he is having some amount of money in his pocket. His money income is not totally exhausted. There are certain points which is on the right of the budget line, S, T and U. These are the commodity bundles. These commodity bundles are unaffordable, or this shows the budget constraint. Our consumer cannot purchase S, cannot purchase the commodity bundle T, or cannot purchase commodity bundle U right now with his limited money income. If his income increases, may be possible that he is in a position to purchase these commodity bundles at the same time. Now, some observations. Budget line is AE. It's clear to you students. Budget line is AE, which shows entire income is spent on good 1 and good 2. Second, attainable combinations are shown. What are the attainable combination means all those commodity bundles that our consumer can have. Definitely, our consumer can have all the commodity bundles lying on the budget line A, B, C, D, E. At the same time, N, P, Q is also there. So all the bundles that our consumer can have with his limited money income and with the given price of the two commodities are known as the attainable combinations. Attainable combinations are shown by, first point, all points on AE where P1 X1 plus P2 X2 equals to M. That means which satisfies the equation of the budget line. For example, A, B, C, D, E, and all the points to the left of the budget line AE, where P1X1 plus P2X2 is smaller than N. If our consumer is purchasing commodity bundle N or P or Q, he is spending some amount of money, but remember that expenditure is always less than the money income of the consumer M. Money income means M. So on the line P1X1 plus P2X2 is equal to M. On the left side of the line, P1X1 plus P2X2 is smaller than M. And on the right side, if our consumer wants to go to S, T and U, budget is a constraint. S, T and U, if he is wants to go, what we are finding? Our expenditure will be more than the budget line. Simply, they are known as the non-attainable combinations. So, attainable combination means all the lines on the budget line and all the points on the budget line and all the points inside the budget line. And non-attainable combination means all the points which lies on the right-hand side of the budget line, for example, S, T and U. Non-attainable combinations are shown by P1X1 plus P2X2 greater than M. That means the expenditure made by the consumer should be greater than the money income. Of course, since our consumer is having only a limited amount of money income of M, so our consumer cannot have these commodity bundles. And hence, they are known as the non-attainable combinations, are shown as P1X1 plus P2X2 greater than M. For example, the points S, T and U lying on the right hand side of the budget line. Okay, dear students, I have tried to give you the initial idea of the ordinal utility analysis. In my next lecture, I will discuss regarding the budget line in details, and after that, we will start the indifference curve. Ultimately, we have to learn the consumer's equilibrium by Hicks-Allen indifference curve approach. We have started, I have given some idea about the budget line in this lecture. In our next lecture, we will continue with budget line. We will see the features of the budget line. We will see the shifting of the budget line and rotation of the budget line. And after that, after completion, what is the slope of the budget line also we will have to see. And after that, we will go to the indifference curve, its properties, its nature, and finally to the consumer's equilibrium. I hope two or three lectures are needed to complete this consumer's equilibrium chapter by ordinal utility analysis. So, take a screenshot of my writings, dear students, and you will just maintain it in your fair copy as a reference along with your prescribed book or any helping book that you are having. You will learn this consumer's equilibrium concept along with my notes. And if you are finding any difficulty, feel free to call me. I will try to solve your problems. In our next class, we are meeting with some more features of the budget line. Budget line in details we will learn. This downward sloping curve, from straight line from left to right, is the budget line. Its more features we will see in our next class. So till then, dear students, goodbye.